And so the Commonwealth is petitioning the governor to reconsider that decision under Bradford versus Knight. I know that it's not exclusively convenient to report, Your Honor, but it's clear that this defendant, the victim, were there for the defendant's grandfather's trial.
Well, doesn't the status of the alleged victim have to be of a certain nature in order to be considered intimidation of a witness?
She was the victim in this defendant's grandfather's trial.
She was a witness in the trial against this defendant's grandfather.
The victim in this particular case in front of us is the same victim on the trial of this defendant was in court today.
Your Honor, I don't believe the report encompasses what is necessary to charge on that particular count. Effectively, she's in the audience. There's no suggestion, Your Honor, even in the report, that she knows specifically that this individual is in fact the victim in the case. And as a matter of fact, she suggests she did know her. But that outside of that,
I'm not sure that factual, just the allegations, I should say, if there's any aspect of the language used or the behavior that was intended to intimidate a witness.
Well, Your Honor, it's my understanding that the witness intimidation charge is not only threatening, but also causing harm to an individual who's a witness or a victim in a trial. This person was a victim in a trial today. And
well, it was not a trial.
Yes, and that's why we're going to
Your Honor, I'll concede it's a pretty broad statute. I'll give it that. But that being said, I just don't think that the facts as presented in this report, and again, Commonwealth always reserves the right to re-petition under a different report. And I just don't think this report in